guys, I'm Shikin. Welcome back to our YouTube channel. Now you're watching episode 5 of my crab show. If you haven't watched yet the previous episode, you can find the link at the description. In this episode, we will be discussing on solid removal using recirculating aquaculture. The most important design criteria for recirculating aquaculture system RAS is to determine the optimal pathway to remove solid. The general idea of husbandry revolves around the idea of caring and cultivation of animal, which is most cases involve providing the animals with nutritious feed. Over time, leftover feed tend to accumulate in the form of solid waste. The byproduct of the metabolic process also generates solid fecal matter. Accumulation of this solid in the culture tank will often result in pollution of the water, resulting in stress and mortality. Hence, it is important for farm operation to periodically remove this solid from the recirculating aquaculture system. In our farm, we operated a sand filter to remove the bigger solid. You might have heard of the sand filtration method before, as this application is also used as the preparation of our daily drinking water and wastewater treatment. Basically, the fact behind this procedure is the same, to remove solid. Mechanical filtration through sand filter involves using some means of constriction to sieve out bigger solid while allowing water to pass through the sieve. As a result, the solid are trapped in this mechanical filter and removed from the recirculating aquaculture system. It is an efficient technology to apply if you are running the farm in high density. However, the sand filter operation might need high maintenance costs in the future. There are also a few other simple equipment that you can use to remove the solid. In our farm, we use a small net to take out the leftover feed from the crab house manually. Last episode, we already demonstrated how we took out the feed from the crab house using the net. Also, we use a filter bag that we put at the outlet pipe. There are many filter bag sizes available in the market, which you can choose based on your preference. Here in the retention pond, we also apply a net partition to help remove some of the solid before going into the sand filter. But of course, using simple filtration does not confirm the removal efficiency. It is relatively popular to utilize foam fractionator in saltwater aquarium for enhanced solid removal. To understand the need for foam fractionator, we need to first understand how foams are created in the culture system. Foaming is a result of excessive protein in the cultured water, either from the feed or dead crab. Sometimes some of the solid will escape the filter as they disintegrate into fine pieces as they flow through the pump. This causes the solid usually less than 30 microns to dissolve into the water, creating a nasty layer of foam. Hence, here comes the need to remove this dissolved protein to reduce the amount of ammonia treatment in the subsequent unit operation. Note that the adoption of foam fractionator technology cannot replace the primary method of solid removal via drum filtration or sand filter. The general idea is for these primary methods to remove 70 to 90% of the solid in the culture system, while foam fractionator will remove the remaining 10 to 20%. Apart from looking to purchase this equipment, you can also opt to attempt to build your protein skimmer. Ideally, you want to first maximize the volume of air bubble created, second, to minimize the air bubble created, and third, increase the retention time of the bubble spent in the column by increasing the height of the column. Note that all skimmers come with a collection cup in which the waste is collected and disposed of daily. The operation of the protein skimmers required daily intervention to adjust the water height by using the valve, and fine adjustment is needed after feeding. We also built our foam fractionator. You can check the video from our YouTube channel for reference. Okay, now I will show you how the water looks like before and after going through the sand filter and foam fractionator. Here is the water from our retention pond, where the water comes from the crab house. Here is the water that comes from the sand filter and foam fractionator. As you can see, the water that does not go through the solid removal process yet contains a lot of particles suspended in the water. This might be the leftover feed and crab feces. Compared to the other water, it shows clear water with no observed particle. We have reached the end of this episode. To recap, in this episode, we already discussed how sand filter and foam fractionator works to remove the solid. In the next episode, we will share with you on biofiltration. Don't forget to subscribe to get notification on the next episode. If you have any question, do drop it at the comment section as we will do a Q&A session at the end of the show. Thanks for watching.